I'm going to destroy him. I'm going to demolish him. I'm going to box him. And then I'm going to punch him. And then I'm going to punish him. And then after the fight, I'm going to help him up and congratulate him for a good fight.
Bruno prepares for his ring entrance, the long walk to the ring. 9 years and 45 days since his first world title attempt against Tim Witherspoon right here at Wembley Stadium. Will it be a different story tonight? Due to go 12 rounds for the WBC title. In the build-up, McCall threatened to do what Joe Lewis did to Max Schmeling and beat Bruno in round one. Bruno already getting to work behind that very good left jab that he has.
Yes, I mean, that's what he has to do. He has to rely on that jab very much. He's got to keep sticking out. It's a solid weapon, and he's landing it well now in.
McCall smiling as the right hand went in, looking at his corner almost arrogantly. He says that he won't be the first to take a back step. Bruno catches him with a left hook on the way in there, though, McCall. Getting the left hook this time. Bruno says, I hit harder than Tyson now.
All Frank's work is coming off that jab. It looks a good punch. The left hook, he's landed a couple of times, looked good. Ooh. Big right hand.
That's encouraging for Bruno. That rocked McCall back. Now McCall having to take the body shot. Bruno was saying when they sparred together, McCall didn't seem to like shots to the belly. Frank hasn't really tried that too much. He's been mostly headhunting.
Again, Bruno just picking up the extra points by using that jab and then punching off of it.
Bruno deserves a world title for everything he's done for British boxing. But if it was a popularity contest, he'd have won it years ago. Right hand was a good shot again from Bruno. So far, so good from his point of view.
Yes, he's doing everything right. McCall just can't find the answers. Nigel Benn there shouting, use the jab, use the jab. He sees it, that's a key weapon, that's keeping McCall off balance. He's not allowing himself to set his feet to land the big punches, and this is good loose work from Bruno.
And there's a rising tide of noise now around Wembley Stadium, because this crowd sense that Bruno might be close.
He's been very much in command and done pretty much as he pleases.
Said before the fight, I'm bigger, I'm fitter, I'm more focused, and a punch harder.
A beautiful uppercut there, just right through the middle of McCall's guard.
At this point, he's just beginning to work McCall over a bit, but he must keep concentrating right the way through, because McCall does have that right hand. McCall caught on the way in by a crunching right hand. McCall is looking at the referee, and that is always a good sign for the other fellow, isn't it? Just giving out a little distress signal.
Yes, he's warning the referee to break them earlier. He feels it just giving Frank a little bit too much time. And McCall landed a good left uppercut there. That just stopped Bruno in his tracks a bit.
Oh, he's let go with another one as well. These are bad moments for Bruno. Caught with two head punches. He needs to hold on here and show some survival instincts.
And that's where Bruno has always been let down in the past. The survival instincts haven't been there.
Left uppercut was a dangerous punch too from McCall. This is the moment. This is the phase I thought might be coming, where McCall just abandoned caution and let the punches fly and would hope that he could get Bruno going. Bruno must come through this.
Yes, he hasn't got a stand with McCall. He can't be drawn into a war, because that's when McCall can be dangerous. Bruno was on top of Lennox Lewis when the same thing happened. He was caught with a big left hook, so he's got to be careful. He's a big winner here. He's got to try and hang on, tie him up, just use his patience and then get back on the jab again.
People watching this have got butterflies in their stomach. It's almost nerve-wracking here. I've been at ringside for just about every fight Frank Bruno has ever had. We never thought we'd see him become a world heavyweight champion, but he seems so close now that he can touch it. There are, what is it, 1 minute, 45 seconds remaining. Look at the clock, top left of your picture, because that's a vital element here now.
Listen, he's got to be a big one. All he's got to do now is just try and mess McCall about, try and survive, keep out of the way, tie him up when he can, wait till the referee breaks him.
For the key point for Bruno tonight, that when McCall has come forward, he's been clever enough, and he wouldn't have been earlier in his career, to tie him up and buy himself some time and halt the assault. And that's what he's doing now again, just messing McCall around. Every second for Bruno is gold dust now.
And there he is, and he's 60 seconds away from being heavyweight champion of the world.
Bob Fitzsimmons did it, Lennox Lewis did it, Herbie Hyde won the WBO version for Britain. Is Frank Bruno going to join that very, very short list? He has, what is it, 40 seconds to survive. Can McCall find an opening? It's very late now. The right uppercut lands from McCall. Blood coming from Bruno's mouth. He's breathing heavily. McCall closes in for what surely is his last throw of the dice. Bruno is picking him off with the jab. Is this Frank's moment of destiny? He switches southpaw again. We are inside the last 10 seconds of the contest. He's caught with a left hand, Bruno. He holds on. The bell's going to go any second. Bruno must be a mile ahead on point, and he must have been the world heavyweight champion with that final bell. He surely has won it. Nigel Benn comes into the ring and lifts him high. Frank Warren punches the air. The call looks somber. There can be no doubt, surely, that Frank Bruno, Franklin Roy Bruno, has entered boxing history for Britain on a momentous night of sport here at Wembley Stadium.
And new
Bruno is the champion.